Good day, fellow investors. Now, exactly a month ago, I made a video about how the stock market is going to continue to go up because Bank of Japan, European banks are still putting a lot of cash into the system. If we look at the chart, my forecasting was excellent. The stock market is even down in the last 30 days. Nevertheless, in the last 5 years, the stock market is really extremely positive. So, what to look now? From a business perspective, the best thing to look at are valuations. And then we'll discuss also something else that's very important. If you look at the price-earnings ratio is around 24 point something. Since 1881, the average price-earnings ratio has been 15.66, so now we are 55% of the average. The lowest point was in 1920 when the price-earnings ratio was about 5. So just before stocks exploded in the 1920s, people were pessimistic about stocks. This means that if you buy in optimism, usually your returns will be lower than if you buy in pessimism. Those who buy now can expect lower returns than those who bought in 2009. Of course, and unfortunately that few people understand that. And I will repeat that sentence 1,000 times. Be greedy when others are fearful, and be fearful when others are greedy. That's counterintuitive, that's counter what 99% of the population does, but leads to higher returns. And when an investor understands that, then really, it is painful in the short term. We have seen some stocks that we covered here that went down 20-30%, or they went up and then again down. But in the long term, if you look at 5-year trends, and that's what I prefer to invest with, 5-year horizon, really multi-baggers can come out of that. If you look at the cyclically adjusted price earnings ratio that uses 10 years of earnings, so the average 10-year earnings, we are now at close to 30. However, the average is 16.77, with the lowest points in 1930, again pessimism, 1933 pessimism, and 1982, when everybody was expecting high inflation and nobody wanted to invest in stocks, especially since stocks went nowhere from 1976 to 1982. And again, if you invested then your returns would have been amazing. If we take a look at global price earnings ratio, China 7.4, everybody expects a crisis there, so banks are very cheap and those have big weights in the index. Russia also very low, so Germany 20.5, France 19.5. So in developed markets you can expect returns of about 5%. If you look at China and then find good companies, you can go to 10-20% easily. Follow this channel, we discuss those kind of investments and perhaps you find something interesting for you. Now, I want to conclude with something that's really disregarded now. Nobody looks at that, and that's price to book value. Book value is what you get. Price is what you pay. And nobody looks at that. If you take a look at the price to book value chart, in the 2000s it was very high, everybody expected an explosion in internet stocks. Then it went down in 2009, especially below price to book value ratio of 2, it means that the equity is half the stock price. And now we are at 3.18, which means that the equity you buy is 3 times smaller than the stock price. This means that if there is a house of $1 million, on the stock market you pay $3 million for it. So no margin of safety in investing in stocks now. And we are 8 year in an economic upturn, so when that shifts, and we have seen with Foot Locker, when that trend shifts, earnings go down and the margin of safety really splashes. Foot Locker's book value was 20, the stock price was 70, so there is no margin of safety there. Now, further, management is doing a lot of buybacks, but let me explain the illogical thing with buybacks. They are buying their own stocks at 3 times or 6 times book value, like Apple. If you look at the S&P 500 earnings that are now at 100 points, the S&P 500 is at 2,400 points. The book value of the S&P 500 is 768 points, which means that the return on equity, equity being 768 points, the book value is 13% for the businesses, 13%. So if they invest, they do the same, replicate their businesses, their returns are around 13% at the moment. However, they are mostly buying back their stocks, where the return price earnings ratio is around 4-5%, which is a crazy thing to do. Why are they not investing in their businesses, growing their businesses? That's a very important question. It leads to productivity, it leads to this being a credit bubble, another credit bubble, and makes me just warn you to be very careful where you invest, or to invest like a swing trader, really taking advantage of the short-term positive trend. So be careful out there. So again, some food for thought: book value, return on equity of the companies, where are they investing? Buffett doesn't do buybacks, so he invests with the 10-15% return he gets from the businesses. He doesn't care about potentially investing on the 6-7% by buying back stocks and pushing stock prices up. Very interesting to dwell about. Look, what are your companies, what are your management doing? Because they are your employees, you're the owner of the company from a business perspective, and the management, the CEO, is your employee, you're his boss. So really look at what's going on there. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Leave your comments below, any ideas, any discussions about stocks that do it right, do it wrong. Share it with us, as we are here to learn together. See you in the next video.